Hi everyone, hope you're all doing great. I've decided to record some short videos to describe some of the questions and answer some of the questions you ask in the group and get in touch more. So today I've selected one of the questions. It's from Dada Rosso. The question is either asking for some help. I can't find in the logic panel the hide option, but only jump to submit. After submit, go to. Anyone could point me in the right direction. So in the formal dashboard, if you create a new form loop and add a title, add some questions to it. Let me add some more questions to show you how it works. I saved my form loop, and in the design tab, you see that by default, your form type is single step, but you can move it to multi-step. You can change it to multi-step or widget. Widget right now is a chat box that opens up in your website, and you can ask questions from your audience to engage them. It's very simple right now. If you click on it, the options there are not much, but you can add your suggestions in our roadmap to add features based on your requirements. But right now, it's a very simple type of chatbot. In the single step, you see that by default, as I said, your form, your created forms will be single step. And if you save it, you see all the questions in the same step. And if you change it to multi-step, you see that each question will be shown in a different page. As you see, question one is in this page, question two is in the second page. So for multi-step, the logic works as jumping. So I answer this question this way, and if I click continue, it will jump to another question. By default, it will jump to the next question, which is email, as you see here. But you can jump from email and from name jump to the choose question, the third question, or you can jump to the fourth question using logic. So the jump logic works in multi-step forms because you're showing each question separately in a separate page. But if your form is single step, the logic works as hide and show. As you see, I answered this question. The jump doesn't mean anything. So if I answer it in some certain way, I can hide another question or show another question. And if you set something in the logic tab, for example, here, I say if the name was Noosh, then hide email. And I save it. So by this logic condition, by default, my email will be shown. And so by default, it will be shown. And if the name was Noosh, it will hide it. So the default will be vice versa of what you put in the condition. Right now, let me refresh it. By default, it will be shown. And if I put Noosh, it will be hidden, as you see it. It just got hidden. And if I change it to show and save it, show and show email, save it, and get back to my form, by default, it will be hidden unless I put Noosh. As you see, it's shown now. So logic works this way. If you put a condition in the show hide, by default, the vice versa will happen. But if you if that condition happens, it works based on that condition. And you don't need to hide it in this situation because it will take care of that. And you can show things here. And the formula will take care of the hiding it. So if I delete this, it will hide it. So so the show hide conditions work in the single step forms, and the jump condition works in multi-step forms. I hope this helped you, and let me know if you have any questions or if you want more tutorials and more community videos, and I will be happy to help. Have a great day, and bye for now.